payment bank licenses have been given, and since then three players have withdrawn from that. I wanted your view on the entire model of payment bank and what's hampering players to get into it, or prompting them to withdraw from it.
Payment banks. Now, I think one has to be sort of careful about this, because we gave out licenses to anybody we thought had the appropriate qualifications to run a payment bank. Now, we presume they did they also analyzed potential business prospects. Now, after doing further analysis and seeing the other players who are coming in, some of them have decided to back out. My sense is that the payment bank works particularly well for those who already have a base of operations and many contact points, and therefore can build upon that. And the classic example is somebody affiliated with a mobile company with many kiosks through which you can do cash in, cash out. So the first license is already with Airtel, and I would presume other mobile operators would also go the full length. We are not overly perturbed that some people decided after analysis that they would not go forward. In fact, it suggests that the licensing has been adequately liberal, and that we have a variety of players coming in. I think that is as it should be, that people will decide whether they should come in or not. Now, I think Mundra Saab has made this point that, you know, people should also acknowledge the fact that it imposed some costs on the assessee, or the assessor, I should say, to go through these applications. We ask for a lot of information from a variety of government agencies. So going forward, we have to find some way that people devote adequate time to understanding whether in fact they should apply or not. The days where licenses were rationed and therefore you had to get in the license because otherwise you wouldn't get it down the line, we hope is in the past. Therefore, when you go forward, do a proper assessment. Don't just go for a license because it's a valuable property to have, but instead do the due diligence on your own, and when you apply, it should be with the intent of fully carrying out. Again, that said, we're not overly perturbed that some people decided to back out.